Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you Amdahl's law, which explains overall speed up factor after enhancement in CPU. So here, my dear students, as if you have one CPU, in that, if you provide some enhancement, then what will be overall speed up factor? That is explained by Amdahl's law. Here, that enhancement of CPU, that could be done by many ways. You can have enhancement by having enhancement in instruction set. You can have enhancement by having pipelining. You can have enhancement by having multiprocessor system, right? So there are many ways by which we can have enhancement in CPU. Here, I'm not going to explain you how exactly we provide enhancement, as there are many ways and all those categories that I'm going to explain you in future coming videos. But here, consider we are providing some enhancement in CPU. And once you provide enhancement, what will be overall speed up factor, that we need to understand by Amdahl's law. And based on this law, definitely there will be one question that will be there in competitive examination. So you should understand the meaning of some terms, right? Once you understand that, definitely you can easily solve any question based on this topic, right? So let me explain that again. Amdahl's law explains what? It explains how CPU's overall speed up factor will be there after enhancement, right? It explains what? How CPU's overall speed up factor will be there after enhancement, right? Let me explain you that. So here, my dear students, Amdahl's law explain how overall speed up factor will be there after enhancement in CPU. Now to understand that, let us consider one CPU. Right now it is there in old condition, right? And here I'm going to explain you instruction set. Now here, as per instructions, let us say there are n number of instructions over here, and I'm just talking about normalized instruction, so I need to consider that as one. See, there can be 500 instructions, there can be 1000 instruction, but here I'm considering that in normalized form. Normalized means what? Instruction divided by total instruction, that is normalized, right? So if 1000 instructions are there, divided by 1000, that is normalized. Why I am talking about normalized calculation here? The reason is, when you provide enhancement, then in terms of fraction, data will be given to you, like 20%, 30%, 50%, right? So at that time, if you go for calculation of how many instructions are there for 30%, how many are there for 50, at that time it will become a bit complex. So to make it simple, right now I'm saying there are instructions which is there with CPU, and normalized is 1, means total is 1, right? It could be 1000, but normalized is 1. Now what we are doing is, here we are having CPU after enhancement, right? So in CPU, what will happen, you see here a portion which is not enhanced, that is 1 minus F. So how much portion that we are enhancing over here? F. So here, my dear students, what we are doing is, in terms of fraction, we are enhancing instructions, right? So let us say F fraction, that is been enhanced over here. So 1 minus F fraction, that is unenhanced. Let me note down that. So this 1 minus F fraction, that is unenhanced. And this fraction F, that is enhanced over here. Now, once you enhance this, data will be given to you, like by what scale it is enhanced. So let us say it is enhanced by scale S. So as if you enhance it by scale S, what will be overall speed up factor? That is what Amdahl's have explained. Now I'm going to explain you that by practical analogy, so that will give you more clarity. Like you see that overall speed up factor, that is depending on what? Ratio of time. So let us calculate ratio of time for older CPU and new CPU. So for older CPU, here we are having, let us say, 1000 instructions, right? So as per it is not enhanced, how much time it will take? It will be taking unity time only, right? So here normalized time that I'm considering, so that will be 1 only, right? But here, if you observe new CPU, so how much time it will take? So for this unenhanced fraction, it will be taking similar time, right? So you see, for this much fraction, which is unenhanced, for that, it will be taking 1 minus F scale amount of time. But the fraction which is enhanced, for that it will be taking less time, right? So you'll be observing, for this enhanced fraction, it will be taking how much time? That fraction f divided by scale, right? So if you observe new CPU, that is taking less time compared to old CPU, right? But see, the fraction which is not enhanced, that is taking similar time in both of this situation, right? So what will be overall speed up factor over here? So to understand that, overall speed up factor, that will be, my dear students, older time period divided by new time period. What is old time period? Old time period is 1 in terms of normalized value. And what is new time period? That is 1 minus f plus f by s. And here you need to remember this, my dear students, this 1 minus f fraction, that is unenhanced. And this fraction, which is f by s, that is enhanced. So here, my dear students, even though if you increase processors by thousands of times in CPU, it is not like speed of CPU will increase by thousands of times. Here, the portion which is happening as per serial data, that will be taking similar time as older CPU, right? So it is not like as if you increase many processors inside CPU, it will be taking less time because of many processors are there. After some number of processors, execution time, that will become constant, right? So I have seen, like, for example, initially you are having one program that is taking 1 millisecond of time to be executed by one CPU, right? So what will happen is, like, as if you provide multiprocessor system, initially that execution time will decrease, but after some number of processor, that execution time, that will become constant. Even though you increase number of processor, that execution time, that will not go down. Why? The reason is, there is a portion which is unenhanced, right? That is what the meaning which was there as per Amdahl's law. Let me explain you this by one example, so that will give you more clarity. So here, to understand that, I'm going to give you one example in which you see, assume a processor given which is widely used for scientific applications. It has both integer and floating point instructions. Now, floating point instructions are enhanced and made 3 times faster than before, and integer instructions are unenhanced. If there are 20% of floating point instructions in program, then find the overall speed up. So here, my dear students, you see, floating point and integer, 2 types of instructions are there. And floating point instructions are how many? 20%. So which fraction that we are enhancing? Floating point. So fraction f, that is 20% means 0.2 over here. So the fraction which we are enhancing over here, that is 0.2. And by what scale we are enhancing? 3 times. So s is also given, that is 3. So here, my dear students, overall enhancement as per Amdahl's law will be 1 divided by 1 minus f, that is unenhanced portion, plus f by s, that is enhanced portion. So in that, you just need to substitute the data. So what will happen? 1 divided by 1 minus f, so that will be 0.8, plus f is 0.2 divided by 3. If you take LCM, then what will happen? 3 will come in numerator. Then 3 into 0.8, 2.4 plus 0.2, 2.6. So 3 divided by 2.6, that will be 1.1538. So here, my dear students, even though we scale that floating point instructions by 3 times, overall speed of this scientific calculator will be increased by 1.15 times only, right? So it is not like if you increase fractional portion by some multiple, then entire system will be having that much enhancement, right? It is not the case which will happen as per Amdahl's law. Still, if anything that you would like to share it with me, please note it down in comment box. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.